So, welcome back. The bad news for the rest of the Premier League is that Manchester City would appear to have got even better. I'm quite right, and we'll see the stats fairly shortly, but can you believe what you're seeing with Manchester City? After last season, 100 points, everything else,
yep.
We thought, that's it. That is the bar. The bar cannot be raised any higher.
No, I'm actually not surprised because of the manager. Pep, he's so relentless and ruthless in everything that he does. He would not allow any of those players to be in a comfort zone. His thing straight away, most probably when they won last year, was, OK, we need to go and we need to do it again. Because that's the sign. When we talk about this City side and last year everyone talking about whether they are one of the greatest teams, if they go on and win it again this year in a style that they're already showing, that's when they're in that category to be able to keep hold of that trophy in the manner that they're doing as well. That's the sign of a great team.
But frighteningly, he's not interested in just doing it again. He wants better.
Yeah, that's him.
He would not, yeah. If you said to most coaches, right, sign for the same again now, they'd snap your hand off,
yeah,
wouldn't
he wouldn't. I've seen him at Brighton, we're 3-4-0 down. He wants more from the players. He doesn't care about the result. He is a genius, And the way that Manchester City are playing, does it surprise me they've got better? No, not at all, because what he's doing is working with a young squad that can only improve. What's scary for me...
Is that right-hand column?
Yeah, that's scary enough.
He'll be disappointed with 68.
He would be. He'd be disappointed with 68. He'd be disappointed with 27 goals. He'd be disappointed with every single stat there because he's not interested in just being first. He wants the perfect game played every game. And what's scary for me is the two centre-halves. Right, so, yesterday, Laporte and Stones, who were the two centre-halves last year we were talking about? Kompany and Otamendi. But the reason they don't concede goals is because they have the ball. And they position their players in a way that is so difficult. And they position the opposition to play in their own half of the whole game because your opposition are just constantly thinking, how do we stop them scoring? How do we stop them playing? So in terms of their counter-press, in terms of the way they move positionally their players up the pitch to stop you in the other team's half, it's an absolute joy to watch. And they didn't score 2 and 3 goals yesterday. But for any young coach or any coach at all, for that matter, to watch the way that they play, the way they position their players, it's a masterpiece. And he is an absolute genius.
But that's the thing as well, when we talk about, oh, it's easy because you can go and buy some of the best players out there. Well, no, because Aguero's a prime example in that. He was already regarded as one of the best strikers in the Premier League with the amount of goals that he scored. But he wasn't happy with him.
No.
He wanted to take him to the next level, and that's what he's so good at. It's not just getting these players. I'm ruthless with them. I want more. And that's the standards that he continues to set at the club.
It's with top players as well. We're talking about Madrid. You know, when I'm talking about a manager going in and creating intensity, they do it for Pep somehow. So David Silva last year, his stats, you know, end product, tackles won. Kevin De Bruyne winning the ball back more than he ever has before. These are two of the most creative players in the world. And he's not happy for them just to create and make goals. He wants more from them defensively. I mean, you see it down on the touchline more than we do. I mean, you know, he's non-stop, even when they're winning. But what... It's very easy to say they've got the best players and they spend more money than anyone else.
Yeah, 100%.
No. You know, United spend a fortune and they don't play like City because Pep is a brilliant coach. I mean, obviously, Jose's a great coach in a different way. But what Pep does is he gives players freedom in a structure. That's silly. It sounds silly, but you play this way for me. And when you get the ball, you show how good you are and you can rotate your positions and he gives them the freedom to play out. For Fernandinho to drop in, get it off the keeper, pop it to Stones. Some of their stuff on that pitch last night in their own defensive third was ridiculously good. And he gives, any manager gives you freedom to do that, make mistakes. But if you don't do the other bits, he doesn't mind you making mistakes when you've got the ball. If you don't put a shift in for him, you won't play. You will not play. And Mahrez, I mean, him running back like I've never seen him before, that's because of Pep. Do you know what I mean? And he deserves great credit, not just because he can go out and buy the best players. That's not it.
Yeah, it's not it. You've seen him do it with Barcelona, with Bayern Munich, the way that they play. With that Barcelona team, you go through the players, Xavi, Iniesta, Messi, Pedro, David Villa. They all had to work at a high intensity. But what allows them to work at such a high intensity, and this is the thing about playing out from the back, he plays out from the back so they can press at intensity because they have the ball. When you have the ball, the game's so much easier to play with in possession and out of possession. And the way he positions his players when they have the ball is when they lose the ball, it's impossible for a team to get two passes in. Yeah. It's absolute genius. For me, the coaching-wise, someone to learn from, the best ever for me in terms of what he's put onto a football pitch at every club he's been at. And people say it's the players, But the performance he get, the performances he gets out of those players is nothing short of magnificent every single week.
I mean, to improve players of that calibre already, that takes something special, doesn't it?
It does. And, well, we were all lucky enough to see the insights in the documentary. Just when he sets up in training, you know, some when you're going through the patterns of play, and sometimes, yeah, it can be at a lower tempo. He was demanding more. It wasn't good enough. Every player he's shouting at. Patterns of play, this is where you just pass it around the back, you switch in. It was like it was a competition, like they were playing at game tempo, which you should be. Like, but it's easier said than done in training. Oh, you need to train as you mean to play. It's easier said than done. He demands that, and that's what we were seeing in the documentary. It was so fascinating, the insights that we got from that, from him.
Now, the International FA Board... Yep, me neither. I've put forward a proposal that there be no substitutions allowed in added time because they feel it is time-wasting and a cynical ploy.
Well, any substitution is then time-wasting, isn't it?
Not necessarily.
Well, if the referee does his job properly...
No, it is a cynical ploy. Some substitutions are for tactical reasons and obviously injury. What they're saying
is... You could have 7 minutes injury time...
Yes.
..and bring on a sub... In the second minute of injury time, he scores the winner with a free kick.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, I was that wrong.
But you know yourselves, you all know, do you not agree that you often see substitutions just to run the clock down?
Yeah.
But that's tactical. It's tactical to go and run the ball into the corner. That's tactical because you're running the clock down.
Yeah, but so, someone can go and get the ball off of you.
Yeah, but
the opposition can't do anything.
Yeah, but it shouldn't. The point is, it shouldn't ever be able to be a tactical time wasting ploy. Because if the officials do their job properly.
100%. The time,
gets added on. So what you're saying is you're taking advantage of the official's inadequacy at the end of a game for not doing their job properly.
And it's not just to run the clock down. You make a sub in stoppage time to stem the flow of the game, kill the flow of the game. That's not just to run the clock down. That's just to change the flow of the game sometimes. You're under pressure. You just... A 30-second break. You get your back four to gather themselves and be ready. So I don't see how you can stop managers from doing that. I just can't. I think that's just going a step too far.
Do you not think it is... Morally wrong, though.
Well, no, I'll tell you what, they'll never do it. They'll never get it through because medical science, statistically, will show that more injuries, fatigue injuries, happen in the final minutes of games than any other point in games. When that documentation is presented to them, they won't be able to do that. You're taking away the choice of bringing off somebody who's hurt and it properly injured and punishing them for what?
You're giving this very short shrift.
No, I'm not.
Well, for the referee, if the referees do their job properly, there's no argument.
But it's great. But if you've earned the right to be a goal up with a minute to go and you've only used two subs, that's great management. Use your third sub. That's part of the game. That's part of coaching. You're taking the power away from coaches from doing their jobs.
But when they sub the player, you get the player to trot over to the far corner.
You do that in 78 minutes, 82. I used to do it with Mark Hughes, he used to give me a wink. I'd shake the ref's hand and I'd be in the far corner, undo my lace, shake the ref's hand. We used to do that all the time.
But you should also be made to jog off at a proper speed.
Why? Just stop the watch.
Stop the watch.
Yeah. Actually, is the answer to take the timekeeping out of the ref's hands and have an independent adjudicator?
No, well, they're all independent, aren't they, the refs?
No, sometimes.
The time.
Yeah, but the fourth official's independent.
There are other ways, surely. I think you're trying to take too much power away from if you, for me, as someone who wants to coach...
This is a cynical ploy on your part, because somebody's holding up a time board, and we have to go right now.
Stoppage time.